It's Thursday, January 17th here in Seoul, and this is Korea's Daily News from Korea Now. I'm Debbie Wan. BTS's latest album, Love Yourself Answer, has remained on the Billboard 200 album chart for 20 weeks in a row. The album is now ranked 78th on the chart, which is down from last week's 59th. But still, this week marks the 20th consecutive week, or the fifth month, that the album has stayed within the 200 ranking. Love Yourself Answer was also number one on Billboard's World Albums chart, with BTS topping the Social 50 chart for 79 weeks in a row, the longest streak on record. Meanwhile, BTS said Tuesday that it's now working on a new album, but the release date and other details have not been disclosed yet. South Korea's foreign minister says the fate of two key inter-Korean projects will be decided in talks between North Korea and the United States. At a press briefing on Wednesday, Foreign Minister Kang Kyung-hwa said since the South Korean government is not at a stage to review the resumption of the Kaesong Industrial Complex and the Mount Kumgang Tour program, she believes that eventually a specific result will be made at the North Korea-U.S. bargaining table. The minister also made it clear that South Korea is hoping for a comprehensive deal on denuclearization and phased implementation. South Korea's biggest Buddhist sect, the Chogye Order, has announced that it will push for a number of joint projects with the North Korean Buddhist community this year, including a stay-over meditation program known as Temple Stay at Mount Kumgang in the north. The president of Chogye Order, Venerable Wonheng, stressed that the joint Temple Stay program will be pursued within the limit of any international sanctions on North Korea. The Buddhist sect is also planning to hold joint inter-Korean festivals this year by inviting North Korean Buddhist officials to the south on Buddha's birthday in May. And those are your top headlines for today. For full-length articles, you can head over to our official Yonhap News website, linked down below. As always, don't forget to subscribe to Korea Now for more daily updates.